Hi everyone, and today I want to show you how I did this kind of image with it's basically a mesh, so we have the skeleton mesh and then it's booled with a fractal, a Vectron fractal, and you can have this strange texture going on. I did that with different fractals, so here I use integer power, which is a fractal in from the second pack, our Vectron pack. Here I used a more hard surface fractal. As you can see here, there's much detail, and I did also a close-up of this part so you can see that it's still a real fractal. And it's not like cheating with meshes, but everything is like a real fractal, so that's the cool thing. I used this technique also for the Mastodon Fallen Torches video. So we had 3D face scan of the band members, and I combined that with some fractals, as you can see here. And that's really cool effect. So this was the fractal that I've combined with their faces. You can see this test, another one, and this is pretty cool. So let's jump to Cinema4D. So what we need now is choose a good mesh. I like this one because it's for free and it's high quality. I'll put the link about how to where to get this, and just open that in Cinema4D like this, and let's reset the scale a bit. So I usually use the figure to get the right proportion, and let's do this 10 times bigger. This is quite good. We don't need the figure. And what we need now is convert this mesh to a VDB object. To do that, you can use a volume builder in Cinema. And we see that it's actually voxelized, but the voxel size is really too big, so let's decrease that to 1. And this is not too bad. So later, when we will combine this VDB with the fractal, it will be slow to calculate. So my recommendation is to save different voxel size VDBs. And to do that, we just need to rename the volume builder to school low. So this is the low resolution version. Let's duplicate this and change the voxel size to 0.1. And as you can see, we have way more detail here. Let's rename this to school high quality. And now we can save the project file. So just rename this one, and now if you want to save the VDB here, you just have to press C or current state to object. You will see that's now a VDB file, and just click save. And let's do the same actually with the low resolution version. So just press C and save this one. Okay, so we have a VDB in high quality and one with the low quality. So in the folder, there's this file here, which is a sample I did with everything ready and the OSL script already compiled and working. Basically, what we are going to do here is combine the volume SDF, which is your school. So let's load the low quality version and connect that to render target. It's pretty nice. And then we have also the fractal. So as you can see now, it's not really good looking, this fractal, because we have to change the bounds here. So let's set 20, 20, and 20. And this is our fractal. So we can change every parameter here, of course, like the, I don't know, the mode, and you can change the angles, make it loop like you want. That's pretty much it. So the fractal here is from my second pack. So if you go to my website, you will see two Vectron packs, and the formula I'm using now is called Uberbulb. So you can create different shapes, different fractals, and it's actually my favorite for the bool thing. And I did this Vectron Operators node, which has two different inputs. One is the volume, so just connect the volume SDF here, and the other one is the fractal. So if we connect the Vectron Operators node here, you will see that we have already a combination of the fractal and the VDB. There's different ways to interpolate the two things. I did all this node, like you can use the union that will have both the fractal and the VDB, or just union round, which will smooth the interpolation, subtract, or inverse subtract. But my favorite is intersect round, because we can get a lot of detail from both the school and the fractal. So just switch it to normal kernel to get more an idea about what I'm doing here. And I want to see actually this part of the school. So to do that, I'm going to change the fractal parameters. Let's try to change mode here. This is kind of interesting. We can also move the fractal. Until you are happy. This is pretty cool. And now that we are happy with the fractal position, we can replace the volume SDF to the high quality one. So just click the high quality. It's going to be slower to calculate and move around, but as you can see, it's not bad. And I've used a diffuse material with the transmission set to a red color, and just connect that to the Vectron Operators node. And now we are pretty much ready to save this and export as package. So I'm going to save that on the desktop. So let's replace this one. So let's go back to Cinema4D, and I have a really simple studio light setup here. And we need to import the standalone file. So you can click import standalone, and let's open the file we've saved before. And something is happening, but I think the scale is wrong. Yeah, this is really too big. So to do that correctly, just downscale that to, I don't know, 0.3. And this should look way better, yeah? So this is the final result, and I just want to rotate that a little bit, so let's try to do something cooler. Okay, like this. That's cool already. And let's put a little depth of field. So camera imager enable and change the aperture. That's right. And going to render as path tracer, path tracing kernel. So this is pretty much it. Now, of course, you can still change the ray epsilon. So if you want more or less detail, for instance, you can change the ray epsilon in the settings. I'll show you in this region here. Let's increase that. Or you can decrease and get more details. That's pretty much it. So I'm going to render this in high quality and I'll show you the result later. So this is the final result. I'm pretty happy with it. Of course, you can go more crazy with the light, with the scene, but I wanted to keep this simple and clean. So after 10 minutes, the render is ready. And I'm pretty happy with it. I like the transmission color from the material. And of course you can use different materials and just go more crazy with it. I just wanted to keep it simple for this tutorial. And I hope you enjoyed.